Hello. Hello.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening. How are you today? How do you feel?
Good night, teacher.
Hello, good evening. How are you?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good night.
Hello. So how was your day? ¿Cómo estuvo su día? How was your day? And how was your weekend? ¿Y el fin de semana? How was your weekend?
Teacher.
Hello?
Nuevamente, no estoy en mi casa. No voy a poder estar con la cámara encendida, solo de oyente.
Okay, perfect. It's okay, Amber.
Gracias.
Okay, thank you very much for informing. All right. So how was your weekend, everybody? ¿Cómo estuvo su fin de semana? How was your weekend? ¿Qué hicieron? What did you do?
Very nice.
It was a nice weekend, excellent. With family, friends. Yes.
My families.
Families, good. There's nothing better than spending time with family. Mm-hmm. All right, good.
I feel glad.
Sorry? All right, everybody. So, les preguntaba cómo estuvo su fin de semana. How was your weekend? A los que se van conectando.
I visit San Salvador. Saturday. And go back to Sunday.
Oh, nice. So you went to San Salvador, Ember?
Hello?
Did you go to San Salvador?
In Saturday.
Oh, on Saturday. And on Sunday?
And Sunday, back at my house.
Oh, you got back to your house. Excellent. Thank you, Ember. Thank you very much. What about your weekend, Juan Carlos? How was your weekend? ¿Cómo estuvo ese fin de semana? Work? No, don't tell me work. No me digas trabajo.
I rest all day.
Oh,
Saturday and Sunday.
So it means you rested a lot. Descansaste bastante.
A lot.
Nice. It's good to know that. Eso es bueno.
The good life of the...
Sorry?
The rich, the famous and rich, Ember.
the good life of the boss.
The good life of the boss, right? Only giving commands. Hey, do this. Hey, do that. Hey, do this. No, but I'm sure, estoy seguro que Juan Carlos is not a boss. He is a leader.
Yes, he is a good boss.
Yeah, so he's not, then don't call him boss, call him leader. All right.
Thanks.
Okay, very good. So let's start. Empecemos entonces. Le voy a pasar asistencia antes de dar inicio. I will pass the agendas, okay? Solo déjenme hacer algo aquí rapidito. Let me do something quickly. Okay, very good. So let's pass the attendance. Vamos a la asistencia entonces. Ana Abigail.
I'm here.
Excellent. Let me get another pen. Okay, Abigail, Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Excellent. Carlos David. Edgar Alexander. Ember Giovanni.
I'm here.
All right. Sarai.
Yo creo que tiene problemas de inter, teacher.
Ah, okay, okay, thank you. Jacqueline, sir.
I'm here again.
All right, excellent. All right, let's see. Jorge Eduardo. Jorge, not connected yet. Okay. Juan Carlos.
Right here.
Good. Luis de Unisi. No está conectado, ok. María Elena. María Elena.
I'm here.
All right, thank you very much. Mauricio? A ver, no se han conectado hoy. Se durmieron por ser lunes. Nelson?
I'm here.
All right. Néstor? Néstor? Okay, let's see. Oscar Arnulfo? No está conectado, Oscar. Siempre se conecta temprano, Oscar. ¿Qué le pasaría hoy? Roxana y Amilet?
I'm here, teacher.
¿Quién? Ah, Roxana, right? Le estaba poniendo falta a Roxana aquí. Ok, Roxana. 18, let me see. Wendy, Natalie?
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Gloribel?
Present.
Jocelyn?
I'm here.
All right. And Yesenia? Yesenia? No, not connected. Okay. Perfect. Okay, let's start with today's class. Let's make a little review. Hagamos un pequeño repaso. Let's make a little review. What did you study last week? ¿Qué estudiaron la semana anterior? What did you study last week? Tell me something you studied. Algo que estudiaron. Something you studied.
Months of the
year. Número
ordinal. Months of the year.
Imperative sentence.
Negative sentences.
Los meses del año.
The months of the year. Months of the year, Mr. Gavarete. The months of the year. What else? ¿Qué más?
Ordinal number.
Ordinal numbers. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, blah, blah, blah. Okay. What else? ¿Qué más?
Direct instruction.
Sorry?
Direct instruction.
I don't get it, Maria Elena. No. Can you repeat it, please? Maria Elena, can you repeat it? Okay, let's see. We don't hear you very well. No se escucha muy bien. We don't hear you very well.
I have to, I need to.
Have to and need to for obligations and needs. Very good. That's excellent. ¿Qué más? What else? Did we study commands? How to give commands? ¿Cómo dar órdenes? Did we study how to give commands? Yes, right. Yes, like for example, hey, write the reports, please. Or hey, do this, please. Do that. Okay, yes. So we studied commands. Very good. But in this moment, let's focus on the ordinal numbers. Do you remember the ordinal numbers? ¿Recuerdan los números ordinales?
First.
First.
Second.
Second.
Third.
Fourth. Fourth.
Fifth.
Six, seventh,
and after seven?
Eight, nine, ten, eleven.
Okay, and we continue with that. So let me show you. Le voy a compartir. So listen. Take a moment and review the numbers. Tomen un espacio de unos 3, 4 minutos y repasen los números porque vamos a hacer una actividad con los números. First, second, third, fourth. Okay, study the numbers for a moment. Estudien por un momento. Al menos hasta el 30. Until 30. If you don't have a screenshot, make a screenshot, okay? Si no tienen una captura de esto, háganla, por favor. Do it. Make it, please. Make a screenshot.
First, second, third, fourth, fifth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 30th, 3rd, 3rd. 30th.
Until 30, please. Just study them until 30. Estudianos hasta el 30. Del 20 en adelante, o del vigésimo diríamos, right? So you say 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th. Y el trigésimo sería 30th. Y luego empiezan otra vez. 31st, 32nd, 33rd, 34th, ¿ok? Okay, let's pronounce once. Pronunciemos una vez con el micrófono apagado. Pronounce once, please. Let's pronounce once. Pronunciemos una vez. Okay, follow my pronunciation, please. Repeat after me, but with the microphone off. Repita después de mí con el micrófono apagado, okay? First. Second. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. Tenth. Eleventh. Twelve. Thirteenth. Fourteenth. Fifteenth. 16th, 17th, aquí la H de S está abajo, ahí en el 18th, ok? 18th, 19th, 20th. 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th, 30th. Okay. Okay, very good. Now we practice the ordinal number. So listen, in the following activity, you will use months and ordinal numbers, okay? So I will repeat. In the next activity, you will use months and ordinal numbers, okay? So January, February, March, April, June, July, blah, 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 okay? Very good. What are you going to do? ¿Qué van a hacer? We will go to breakout rooms. Vamos a ir a breakout rooms. And in the breakout rooms, you will practice using the following question. Van a practicar haciendo uso de la siguiente pregunta. Hey, hold on. Espera un momento. Hold on a moment. So you will practice using this question. When is your... And then you continue, okay? When is your, for example, when is your birthday? When is your birthday? Ah, you say it's on September 15th, for example. Listen, it's on September 15th, el ordinal number, okay? You can ask, también podrían preguntar, you can ask what? Let me go back, déjeme ir atrás, let me go back. When is your, podrían decir, when is your, what? When is your sister's birthday? When is your sister's birthday? Ah, then you say, my sister's birthday is on July 21st, for example, okay? So you will use this question. Vamos a usar esta pregunta para practicar, all right? You can talk about your family. Pueden hablar acerca de su familia. When is your? Es la pregunta. When is your? Okay. So, any doubt? ¿Alguna duda? Any doubt? So, in this moment, we move to breakout rooms and let's practice. When is your birthday? When is your sister's birthday? When is your brother's birthday? When is your mother's birthday? When is your father's birthday? When is your friend's birthday? When is your dog's birthday? Okay? So talk about your family. Hablen de la familia. Talk about your family's birthdays. Okay? So any question? ¿Alguna pregunta? No? I give you 5 minutes. So let's go and practice. Vamos a practicar. Let's go and practice. Use ordinal numbers, please. Usemos números ordinales, por favor. Use ordinal numbers, please. Al grupo 5, Arnulfo. Ahorita mandé la invitación. Hi, Arnulfo. Hello, Oscar.
Okay, Jacqueline.
It's only when speaking. It's only, you don't have to take notes this time. It's only speaking. Es solo hablado. Okay, it's only Speaking. No tomen notas, no es necesario. Don't take notes. Only speak, solo hable. Only speak.
Okay.
Okay, perfect.
Jacqueline, when is your mother's birthday?
Third. March 3rd.
Ya pasó, ni modo.
Todavía cumplo años.
Néstor, when is your mother's birthday?
His birth, her birth is on May.
Okay. No, pero es pecado eso que no te preocupas.
In on May 12th.
Ya le vamos a ir a preguntar, fíjate tu mamá.
Sí, no
se ve muy
convencido.
Ok. When is your... Ana María, when is your Mother's Day? Mother's birthday?
My mother's birthday on May 3rd.
3 de mayo.
Yes.
Okay.
Ya casi.
Juan Carlos, when is your mother's birthday?
Her birthday is April 8th. It's on April 8th.
Teacher, when is your birthday?
My birthday is on September 15th.
Hey, yes, calculó bien su mamá.
Sorry.
Calculó bien su mamá para hacer fiesta, disfrutar un solo la independencia.
Yes, that's right.
Con eso se independizó.
Yes, totally.
Okay, when is your father's birthday, María Elena?
April 40. 14. ¿Cómo se dice 14?
Uy, 40, el día 40.
No, 14 es, ¿cómo?
14.
De esos 14, ¿se puede decir 14 o 14 o solamente se puede decir?
No, both.
De las dos.
Yeah. Both.
Ese me hace más fácil darle el acento en la última por el TH.
Yes, it's okay. It's okay, no problem. Está bien. 14.
Ah, ok.
Yeah.
Your mother birthday, así es. Primera es mother. Hazel.
My mother's birthday. On August
30th. Yes, with TH, con la TH al final. 30th. Yeah.
My mother's birthday on October and on August 30th.
Yes.
Okay. When is your uncle, no sé cómo se dice, birthday, Roxana?
Uncles.
Uncle.
Uncle's birthday.
My uncle's birthday in April.
September.
28. Me dijiste que el primero en era June 16.
15. Y el second dijo que es September
28.
September.
Vamos, te tengo duda en el 23 de your son Mauricio,
May 20. Teacher, when is your birthday?
I'm sorry, the microphone. Okay, yes, tell me.
Yes, when is your birthday, teacher?
When is my birthday? My birthday is on September 15th.
September
15th. Exactly. September
15th. Un TH al final.
That's right.
Okay. Birthday.
Different.
How are you?
How are you?
How are you?
Estamos diciendo que otra pregunta le agregamos al what. ¿Cuál es tu fecha de nacimiento?
Yes.
Pero ya no son números ordinarios, ¿verdad, teacher?
Sorry.
Ya no son números.
Hola, Saraí.
La respuesta que hay con
Saraí, perdón, no te escuché. Hola, Saraí.
Se le congeló.
Y a mí porque
para preguntar la edad ya no son números ordinales, ¿verdad?
No. Ajá. Remember, ordinal numbers are only for days, solo para fechas. Por eso la vez pasada practicamos acerca de días festivos. When is Mother's Day? When is Teacher's Day? When is Christmas? All right? For dates only, solo para fechas, for dates. Okay?
Teacher, when is your birthday?
Oh, my birthday. Guess. Adivinen, guess. Which month?
De aquí somos de octubre.
Close. July? Very close, muy cerca.
September,
yes. My birthday is on September 15th.
15,
no, el 15. El día de la independencia. Very patriotic, I know.
How are you, teacher?
Okay. Bien. Vamos a ver.
All right.
Okay.
Chao.
Okay, very good. I guess, well, everybody's getting back. Están regresando algunos todavía. All right, so the question is, when is your birthday? Or when is your mother's birthday, right? Yes. Okay, let's see, Ana Beatriz. Ana Beatriz, when is your birthday?
My birthday is on December 2nd.
Good. In or on?
On December 2nd.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Beatriz. December the 2nd. Very good. Sarai, when is your birthday?
My birthday is on October 3rd.
October 3rd, second, third, oh my God. Okay, thank you very much. Arnulfo, when is your birthday?
My birthday is September 23rd.
September 23rd, all right. So you are from the same month of my birthday. All right, that's very good.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, Arnulfo. Jacqueline Garcia, when is your birthday?
My birthday is April 13th.
Oh, good. April 13th. Thank you very much. Almost on vacation, almost on vacation. Good. Okay. Thank you, Jacqueline. So for everybody, para todos, the pronunciation of abril is not April, it's April. Remember that, April. Porque veo que muchos han estado equivocando en eso. It's April. April, and not April. Okay, very good. Let's see, Mauricio. When is your birthday, Mauricio?
My birthday is on April 10th.
April 10th, excellent. Thank you very much. Nestor, when is yours?
My birthday is on November 26th.
26. All right. Thank you very much. Roxana, when is yours?
My birthday is October 5th.
October 1st. October 1st. Okay. Thank you very much. What about you, Juan Carlos? When is yours?
I don't. No cumplo año yo.
Ah, really?
Acepte que ya tiene 60.
It's on March 3rd.
It's on March 3rd. All right. Thank you very much, Juan Carlos.
I have 23 years old.
20 years old.
23. Oh, sí, yeah.
Really? I am 15 then. Entonces, I am 15, okay?
Good, good. Like me.
Yes, thank you, Juan Carlos. All right, let's see, Gloribel. How old are you? Oh, oh, no, it's not how old are you. It's, como estamos hablando de edad, ya le estaba preguntando how old are you, Gloribel, okay.
Hay que empezar a preguntar, teacher.
When is your birthday?
My birthday is on January 29th.
29. Okay.
20?
Nine. Okay. Thank you very much, Rodibel. Okay, one last. Nelson. Nelson, when is your birthday, Nelson?
My birthday is in April 10th.
On April?
10th.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Gavarrete. All right, so the idea of this activity was to use ordinal numbers, okay? Now I ask, ahora pregunto. ¿Hasta qué porcentaje manejan los números ordinales ahorita, los que hemos estudiado? Más o menos del 1 al 31. Tell me one percentage. Dígame un porcentaje, 20%, 50%. 70%, so what percentage? ¿Qué porcentaje?
20%.
Really?
50%.
50%, better. Ya va mejorando, it's getting better, all right. María Elena?
Si lo veo un poquito más. Ah, no, no, si lo estoy viendo un poquito más.
The idea is not to see it, to see the numbers. Just to note them, hay que saberlos, okay? You have to note them. All right, very good. So let's move on. Vamos a la siguiente actividad. So for today, we have unit number 3. Para hoy tenemos la unidad número 3. Básicamente, estamos a mitad del módulo 2, ¿verdad? Y tenemos la unidad 3. Unit number 3. Schedule events at the workplace. What is schedule events? ¿Qué es schedule events? Any idea?
Programar eventos.
Ajá, programar eventos. ¿Alguien más? Schedule events at the workplace. Aquí es un adjetivo, Juan Carlos.
Una lista de eventos.
Eventos programados.
Ah, exactly, exactamente. So it would be schedule events, eventos programados. Schedule events at the workplace. Eventos programados en el trabajo, all right? Schedule events. All right. To start with the unit, we have two questions. Para empezar con la unidad, tenemos dos preguntas. Number one, who schedules the events at your workplace? Who, right? Which person? Who schedules the events at your workplace? Maybe you can say my boss, my supervisor, or what? My CEO, or my co-worker, I don't know. What are some events that are taking place the next week? Listen to the question. What are some events that are taking place the next week? ¿Cuáles son algunos eventos que tomarán lugar la otra semana o que sucederán la otra semana? Maybe you can say, oh, a meeting, a visit to clients, or what else? ¿Qué más puede ser? What else can be? Maybe you can say a conference, una conferencia. I don't know. What else? ¿Qué más podríamos contestar acá? What else can you answer here? What are some events that are taking place the next week?
Vacation.
Vacation, you say. Oh, nice. Vacation, says Oscar. What else? ¿Qué más?
A meeting.
A meeting? Only that? Okay, two questions, dos preguntas. Who schedules the events?
Video conference.
Sorry?
Video conference.
A video conference, excellent. A video conference, good. So please, in this moment, answer the two questions. Contesten las dos preguntas. Who schedules the events at your workplace? And what are some events that are taking place the next week, right? I give you 2 or 3 minutes. Le doy 2 o 3 minutos para contestar las preguntas. Page 29, página 29, page 29, all right? Page 29, página 29. So answer the 2 questions. Contestemos las 2 preguntas. Answer the 2 questions, please. Okay, are you ready? When you finish, put the hand up, please. Cuando terminen, ponen la manito siempre, okay? Put the hand up when you finish, please. Jacqueline, Jacqueline García, ¿cómo va con el trabajo de la plataforma? ¿Todo bien?
¿En qué aspecto?
Con las tareas. ¿Todo bien?
Sí, había tenía la confusión porque me había puesto, cuando les empezaba a hacer, me hacía que me estaba metiendo, vi otros videos, pero que no eran del grupo, entonces por eso tuve la duda. Entonces me salía y después me llevaba al módulo que estoy. No sé si eso hubo un problema o así era o qué.
No, realmente debería estar en el módulo que estamos, no en otro módulo.
No, no sé, cuando yo le daba el siguiente, él me daba la secuencia para seguir los por eso le hacía yo la consulta.
Ah, los videos.
Sí, pero eran videos de clases.
Ah, ok. Sí, sí. Es que como se van actualizando los videos, a medida, digamos, ya se dio esta clase, suben el video de la clase. Ya quitan los videos cortos, van quitando los videos cortos y van subiendo los de la clase.
Uh-huh. Pero no a la nuestra, teacher, porque vemos gente diferente.
Ajá.
¿Cómo así?
Sí, teacher, son otro, es otro video de otro teacher, de otro grupo.
Ah, ok.
Yo he visto pedacitos ahí.
¿Siempre aparece en el video?
Como sí, que estuviera dando nuestra clase, solo que es otro teacher y obviamente sí, otros alumnos.
Entiendo. Sí, solo una pregunta nada más, pero en lo que de las clases que ya van pasando, siempre les aparece el mismo teacher.
Pues no sabemos quién es el teacher ahí.
Sí, sí.
Digamos, en las clases de la semana pasada. ¿Alguien ha visto las clases de la semana pasada? No, nadie.
No, teacher, no hemos revisado y como después, vea, prácticamente casi o un día después o en el mismo día, pienso, vea, que hacemos la tarea de la mayoría, entonces a mí me sale otro teacher.
Ah, sí, sí, es que...
Entonces después como, ya no reviso.
Ah, como la idea es que ustedes vayan avanzando. Entonces, como esa clase todavía no está subida, como no se ha dado esa clase... Les ponen un teacher ahí, que es el que les da clase a todos los de los grupos, prácticamente. Este video es acerca de la actividad que van a completar. Es por si algunos quieren avanzar para que hagan un pequeño repaso con ese teacher que aparece ahí, que dicen ser.
No, teacher, es una clase igual que la de nosotros, porque incluso hasta el final son 2 horas y más, vea. Da también los 10 minutos para un estudiante así. O sea, la clase personalizada la da también.
Ah, entonces lo que me están diciendo es que es el video de 2 horas y
media. De otra clase. De otra clase.
Ah,
ya lo cambiaron, teacher.
No había entendido. Voy a hacer la consulta.
Consulte mañana, porque ya, en planilla ya no va a salir.
I have enough evidence. Tengo suficiente evidencia de que doy las clases. Ok, no es. Voy a preguntar entonces porque... Entiendo que el video que les debería aparecer es el de la clase de nosotros, no el de la clase de otro teacher.
Por eso yo le escribí a usted el sábado consultando si yo le debía o si le aparecía todo el avance que yo había hecho.
Sí, sí. Porque a mí me duda. En el caso de los que me consultaron fue Loida y sí, Jacqueline también. Ahí ya le respondí porque revisé en ese momento. Eso estaba bien, creo.
Sí, teacher, creo que solo esta semana ha sido, porque la semana pasada aparece, no, la primera semana, aparecía un videito corto.
Ajá.
Eso sí.
Ese video cortito aparece normalmente, pero voy a hacer la pregunta a Willans, ¿ok? Vamos a ver quién más le estoy preguntando, porque yo no quiero que nadie se me quede sin hacer las tareas de la plataforma. Néstor. Hi, Néstor. Are you there? ¿Cómo vamos, Néstor, con el trabajo de la plataforma?
Yes, I'm. Ya, Mistran ya estuvo.
Ah, ok. Sección 1, 2 y el midterm, ¿ya estuvo?
Ya.
Ok, perfecto. Revisaré entonces. ¿Alguien más que vaya retrasado? Me interesa, ¿verdad? Porque prácticamente si no completan esto, se van a... quedan fuera del módulo. Yo no quiero que nadie de ustedes, que ninguno de ustedes quede fuera del módulo solo porque se olvidó completar lo de las tareas, ¿ok? Muy bien, very good. So, did you finish writing the question, the answers for the questions? ¿Terminaron las respuestas? Did you finish?
Sí, pero una pregunta. Yes. ¿Cómo se dice cancillería?
How do you say?
Cancillería. How do you say cancillería?
Cancillería. Let me check because I don't remember. No recuerdo ahorita, pero voy a verificar ahorita. Let me check quickly. Voy a revisar rápidamente por acá. So, did everyone finish? ¿Todos terminaron? Yeah. Okay, let's see. The ones who haven't participated. Wendy, Natalie. Who schedules the events at your workplace, Wendy, Natalie?
Principal peers and teachers.
The principals and the teachers. Okay, very good. Yes. Second question. What are some events that are taking place the next week?
A meeting with my colleagues.
Okay, you have a meeting with your colleagues. Excellent, thank you very much. Okay, let's see, Maria Elena. Maria Elena, who schedules the events at your workplace, Maria Elena?
Sometimes manager, co-workers, and me.
Oh, everybody, nice. I like that. That's cooperative planning. Okay, what are some events that are taking place the next week?
Departmental education de San Vicente
y de La Paz.
All right, very good. So what events do you have in those places? ¿Qué eventos tienen? What events do you have?
No sé cómo se dice. Departmental Education.
Okay,
Departmental Education, La Paz y San Vicente.
Oh, you can only say visits.
Visits.
Okay, that's an event, okay? Thank you very much. Okay, let's listen to, vamos a ver, who hasn't participated here. Néstor. Okay, Néstor, who schedules the events
Hello?
At your workplace? Yes.
The schedules events is Mrs. Cecilia.
Okay, Miss Cecilia, is she your boss is or your supervisor or what?
She is a project manager.
Okay, nice, that's excellent. Next question. Let me see, I don't have the question here. Yeah, it's here. The next question is, what are some events that are taking place the next week?
Have a meeting in office. Visit some schools. And have a meeting on Minet.
Oh, good. Have a meeting at Minet. Thank you very much. Okay, one last. Un último participante. Yeah. One last participation. Okay, let me see. Ana Beatriz.
Yes.
Who schedules the events at your workplace?
It's a supply chain project manager.
At the project manager. Excellent. Let's see. Oh, I forget the last question. What are some events that are taking place the next week?
A presentation, the CCI project.
Okay, very good. That's excellent. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everybody, because I know everybody has the answers. Now look. Look at the following conversation. Look at this conversation and look at this conversation and think. Is the conversation in present, in past, or in future? So read the conversation quickly. Lean la conversación, read the conversation, and the question is, Is the conversation in present, in past, or in future? Can you read the conversation? Leana, read it, please. Don't tell me the answer right now. Ahorita no me digan la respuesta. Don't tell me the answer in this moment. Just read the conversation. And the question is the conversation present, past, or future? Continue reading. Sigan leyendo. Continue reading, please. Okay, stop, please. Deténganse, stop, please. Okay, let's see, Jocelyn, Joanna. Question for you. Is the conversation in present, in past, or in future?
Present, it's past, ¿cómo? Pasado.
In past, in present. Do you agree with the mass? Do you agree? ¿Están de acuerdo? Do you agree?
No.
Present and future.
Present.
It's in present. Juan Carlos says in present. Vamos a votar ahorita entonces. Vamos a ver. Let's vote. Votemos.
Present continuous.
Who says it's in present? ¿Quién dice que está en presente que levante la mano? Who says it's in present?
So para mí sería gerundio, pero no sé si entra en present.
Okay, perfect. Okay. Lower you. Okay, put the hands down. Bajen la mano. Bajen la mano, la mayoría dice. Who says the conversation is in past? En pasado, in past. Jocelyn Joanna, only Jocelyn Joanna. Hands down. Who says the conversation is in future? Nobody?
Both.
Okay, let's see. Who says the conversation is in present and future? ¿Quién dice que la conversación está in present and in future? Okay. I know. Maybe your confusion is that the conversation is in present because they are using the tense present continuous. Porque están usando el presente continuo. All right? Maybe that's your confusion. But let me tell you, déjame decirles. The conversation is in future. The conversation is in future. Hey, but teacher, come on. But it's the present continuous, and the present continuous is for actions in the moment. Pueden decirme algunos, y ya sé que ahorita Juan Carlos está pensando que el present continuous es para acciones en el momento, y probablemente Oscar también y varios, ¿verdad? Okay, you're right. But this time the conversation is, or the intention of the conversation is a future intention. Es una intención futura. It's a future intention. Let's go and check again. Vamos a revisar otra vez para sacarlos de la duda. Okay, now look. There are some expressions. It says, hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is presenting the company in the yearly conference? Now I ask. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference? Now I ask, Did the conference take place already? ¿Ya tomó lugar? ¿Ya pasó la conferencia? No, no, right? No, no. Second. Well, hey, Peter. Well, Maria is. But Julie is attending the conference this year. Julie is attending the conference this year. Present or future?
Future.
Future. Future. Julie is attending the conference this year. So she will attend the conference. Ella va a atender la conferencia. O ella va a estar en la conferencia. So, I see. But if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentations for the CEO? Next week. What is next week?
Future.
Future. What is next week? La otra semana, right?
Future.
La otra semana, so it's future. Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant. Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it. Committee. I am informing the committee about it. Good. Now, who says the conversation is in future? Ahora que levanten la mano aunque dicen que la conversación está en futuro. Veo bien dudosos a algunos todavía. A ver, let's see. Any doubt? ¿Alguna duda? Any doubt? Mauricio, do you agree with me or you don't agree? Mauricio, ¿está de acuerdo o no está de acuerdo?
Teacher, yo estaba pensando que era en pasado porque igual vaya hablado de que ella también va, o sea, ella misma va a organizar pues la conferencia de, va a atender la conferencia de este año.
Jocelyn, but you are saying, ella va a atender la conferencia de este año, so is that past or future?
También, o sea, ajá, o sea, como que la atendió y la iba a atender y entonces...
No, no, it says, is attending. Ok, dice, is attending. Ok, is attending, good. Now, question for everybody. Oh, Mauricio, sorry. Do you agree or disagree with me? Mauricio, ¿en acuerdo o en desacuerdo que esté en futuro?
It's future. Sí, nos tenemos que percatar de del tiempo. Es yearly, next week.
Exactly. I understand. Now, the question for everybody is, I will ask this question in Spanish. ¿Quiénes de acá han estudiado el presente progresivo o el presente continuo para acciones en el momento? Okay, Saraí. Well, ¿quién más?
I don't remember.
Por ejemplo, cuando dicen, in this moment, I am giving a class. I am giving a class in this moment, or I am speaking English in this moment, or you are attending a class right now. Ahora sí? Do you remember now? Ahora sí recuerdan? Yes, this is present continuous. Yes, y eso es lo que vamos a estudiar hoy. Solo que con una intención en futuro. Okay? Very good. Déjenme pasarles asistencia rápidamente because it's time for the attendance. Okay, let's see. Let me pass the attendance quickly. Y luego vamos a pequeño receso y luego sí entramos en el tema. Okay, let's see. Ana Abigail.
I'm here.
Good, thank you. Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Carlos David. Edgar Alexander mandó un mensajito por ahí. Y Amber. Hazel Saraí.
I'm here.
Good. Jacqueline Lisset?
I'm here.
Jorge? Juan Carlos?
I'm here.
Linda? María Elena?
I'm here.
Mauricio?
Present.
Nelson?
I'm here, teacher.
Néstor?
I'm here. Oscar? I'm here.
Okay, Oscar?
Present, teacher.
Rosana?
I'm here, teacher.
All right. Natalie?
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, Gloribel.
Present.
Jocelyn.
I'm here.
Roberto Antonio. No, Roberto Antonio nunca se conectó. Yesenia. Yesenia, ¿no está? No. Okay, perfect. So listen, after the break, después del receso de dos minutos, vamos a estudiar el tema en el que estamos. Okay, so let's go to the break, 2 minutes. Tomemos 2 minutos de receso. Let's take 2 minutes break. 2 minutes, please. Okay, the time is over. Okay, let's carry on. Continuemos. Let's carry on. All right, listen. So basically, let's start with the explanation of the topic. Empecemos con la explicación. Let's do it quickly. Okay, now listen. Okay, listen. So basically, we will study. Pay attention carefully here. Aquí sí quiero que todos estén muy atentos. Okay? I want you to be paying attention. Quiero que estén poniendo atención, ¿ok? Yo sé que ponen atención, pero aquí quiero que estén más enfocados de lo normal, ¿ok? So listen, basically we have the present continuous, ¿ok? Present, we have the present continuous. And now listen, and in the present continuous, we have what? We have pronouns, tenemos pronombres. But we have three important things. Tenemos tres cosas muy importantes. We need to use am, is, or are. And we need to use a verb, un verbo, a verb with ing, un verbo con ing, a verb with ing. Okay? Very good. Now, I ask, ¿para qué pronombres usamos el am? For I, right? Para el I. El is, for he, para él, for she, and for
he,
y para ella. El are, se usa para you,
we,
and
they.
And they, you, we, and they. All right, so this is important. So I say, for example, I am. I say, he is, she is. It is. You are, we are, they are. And the verb with ing. Y el verbo debe ir con ing. All right? Now, let me give you one example. Déjenme darles un ejemplo. So let's see this example. I am, for example, I am checking. Luego la ing en el verbo. I am checking email. For example, I am checking email tomorrow. I am checking email tomorrow. Okay? So the verb to be puede ser una forma, puede ser am, is, or are. Y luego el verbo con ing. The verb with ing. I am checking email tomorrow. Another example, otro ejemplo. Usando she. She is supervising. She is supervising the employees. She is supervising the employees. What? Next week, for example, la otra semana. Next. Oh, sorry. She is supervising the employees next week. Next week. El is. La ing en el verbo. She is supervising the employees next week. Y una expresión de tiempo en futuro normalmente. Because the intention is future. Porque la intención es dar una oración en futuro. One last example. Un último ejemplo. Usando they. Ellos o ellas. They are attending. They are attending two meetings. Sorry. They are attending two meetings on Monday, for example, in future and futuro. On Monday. They are attending two meetings on Monday. So I go again, voy otra vez y digo, and I say, tenemos el are, la ing en el verbo y una pequeña expresión en futuro. They are attending two meetings on Monday. Do you have any question?
¿Cómo entonces se traduciría o cómo diría esa frase que acaba de escribir?
The last one, la última.
Para entenderla en español.
They are
de cualquiera.
Ok, the last one. Veamos la última. They are attending two meetings on Monday.
Uh-huh.
Ellos van a atender dos reuniones la otra semana. Van a atender o van a tener. Van. Yes? Or if I say, she is checking merchandise tomorrow. Ella va a revisar la mercadería mañana. She is checking merchandise tomorrow, okay? And it's future. Y la intención es en futuro, okay? So, any other question? ¿Otra pregunta? Any other question? Do you have any other question? You can ask the questions right now. Pueden hacer preguntas ahorita. You can ask questions right now. Everything okay? ¿Todo bien? Everything okay? Yeah. Okay, perfect. Now, one more thing. Una cosa más tal vez. One more thing maybe. Now listen. To put ing, para poner la ing, a veces seguimos algunas reglas. For example, to put ing, right? We have some verbs. Tenemos algunos verbos. For example, the verb what? Let me think about one verb. Le ponemos ing a la mayoría de verbos. We put ing to the majority of the verbs, right? Tell me some verbs. Díganme algunos verbos, por favor. Tell me some verbs, please. De lo que hemos estudiado. From the ones we have studied.
Work. Play. Check.
Sorry?
Play.
Play. Play. Tell me another one. Otro.
Bye.
Call. Call. And any other?
Mil.
Sorry?
Mil. O mil. No sé cómo se dice comer.
Meeting.
Eat. Eat.
Meal.
Eat. Eat. Any other? Otro?
Bye.
Bye. All right, bye. Very good. ¿Otro? Any other?
Sleep.
Sleep. All right.
Cook.
Sleep. Any other? ¿Otro?
Walk.
Walk. Okay.
Walk.
Very good. Walk. Very good. So, basically, for the verb, we only put it ing. Aquí entonces diríamos playing, calling, eating, buying, sleeping, and walking, okay? Yeah, easy as that, así de facilito, as easy as that, okay? All right, now, so in this moment, we will make pairs, and just keep in mind, lleven en mente, the conversation is in future. The conversation is in future, okay? So, let me show you the conversation again. Here you have the conversation, okay? So let's take a moment and let's repeat the conversation. Tomemos un espacio para repetir la conversación. Okay, so please, with the microphone off, con el micrófono apagado, with the microphone off. Hello, Henry. Okay, let's repeat, repitamos. Hello, Henry. I have a question. I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference? Who is representing the company in the yearly conference? Representing. Conference. Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is. But Julie is attending the conference this year too. So, but Julie is attending the conference this year too. So, I see, but if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentations for the CEO next week? I see, but if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentations for the CEO next week? Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant. Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it. Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Repeat committee, please.
Yes, committee. Committee. Committee.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's okay, no problem. All right, so the conversation is on page 29. La conversación está en la página 29. The conversation is on page 29. Okay, so listen, we will go and practice the conversation with no changes. Vamos a practicar y no vamos a hacer ningún cambio. Make no changes, please. All right? So we will go in pairs. Vamos a ir en parejas. We will go in pairs. Okay? Are you ready? ¿Listos? Okay, let's go. Vamos. Let's go in pairs.
attending, who is delivering the presentation for the CEO next week?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Okay. Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference?
Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too, so.
I see. But if you're attending, who is delivering the presentation for the CEO next week?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Okay. Hello, Henry. I have a question. We're representing the company in the yearly conference.
Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too. So?
Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference?
Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too. So,
I see. But if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentations for the CEO next week?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Okay. Hey, hello.
Y nos anda siguiendo.
Teacher, yo me perdí en la explicación.
A ver, let's see.
Sí, que ahí cuando I am, is, are, se hizo unas.
Y was a mess, era un desorden eso.
Exactly.
I'm sorry.
Bueno, la cosa es que tengo am, is, y are más el verbo with ing.
Exacto.
¿Sí? Yes. Okay. Vaya, pero para is puedo usar he, she, it, algo así.
He, she, and it. He, she, and it. Is, it is.
Ok. She, it is. Ok. Y para are, you, we, they.
Exacto.
Porque son plurales.
Yes. Yes.
O sea, siempre manejando el verbo más el gerundio prácticamente, que es el
ing. Exacto, exacto.
Ah, okay. Ok, por eso es que aquí dice is attending, is representing, is informing.
Exactly. So, yeah. Basically, in the conversation, we have examples of the topic. Tenemos ejemplos del tema.
En este caso sería but Julie, pero Julia va a atender.
O atenderá prácticamente.
Atenderá. Pero el problema es que, I will say this in Spanish because it's very important. El problema es que hay una gran diferencia entre decir atenderá y va a atender. En inglés, in English, right? Yes, cuando digo atenderá, es una predicción. It's a prediction. Pero cuando digo va a atender, es porque hay un plan. Es porque ya se sabe que así va a ser, es real. Pero en cambio, si digo atenderá, es algo irreal, es algo incierto.
Yeah.
In English, right?
Ahí está la respuesta a las preguntas.
Exacto.
Ok, perfecto.
Pero entonces, teacher, para salir de mis dudas, el informing, todos los que terminan los verbos ing, es lo podemos ocupar tanto en presente como el gerundio, como tal.
Sí,
y,
I get your point. El detalle es que aquí en ese momento el presente continuo se está usando para acciones futuras, pero se puede usar para acciones que yo estoy haciendo en el momento también. Ok, por ejemplo, yo puedo
solo decir... Solo para esos dos aplica.
Exactamente, only for two, solo para esos dos nada más. Y puede ser para acciones también, hablando del presente. Hablando del presente. Puede ser para una acción que no es permanente. Por ejemplo, puede ser these days, estos días, these days, I am working at inglés corporativo. These days, estos días, pero puede ser que no sea algo permanente. Cuando hay algo que no es permanente, también uso la misma estructura. I use the same structure.
En ese momento puedo decirle I am working with you.
Exactly. So you can say, I am studying English at inglés corporativo. Porque posiblemente el tiempo va a terminar.
Uh-huh. Okay.
No me puedes pegar.
That's good. Cool. Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Let's continue. Hello, Henry.
Next week.
Yo creo, Nelson, que ahí no es July, sino que es July.
July. Ah, porque July sí. Es julio, ¿va?
Ah, July es julio. Ahí es July.
Ah, I see, but it's a July. July.
Sí, July.
July. Ah, okay, July. Achiba is a July is attended, go is delivered the presentation for the CEO next week. Bueno, ya lo sacaron.
CEO.
Bueno.
Okay, I guess the others haven't finished. Creo que no han terminado los demás. I think they haven't finished. Ya vienen, ya están regresando. They're coming back. All right, very good. So listen, just as a quick review, como un pequeño repaso, as a quick review. In the conversation you practice, you have some examples about the topic. Tienen algunos ejemplos del tema, ¿verdad? And the conversation is in future. And that's the structure you use. Esa es la estructura que se usa, okay? That's the structure you use. All right, so let's listen to some presentations. Escuchemos algunas dos presentaciones, o tres. Okay, let's listen to Roxana y Amilet. Who is your pair, Roxana?
It's Hazel.
Okay, Sarai. Hi, Sarai.
I am Henry.
¿Puede convertir la conversación, teacher, please?
Yes, of course, por supuesto, of course. There you go, ahí está, there you
are.
Okay. Hello, Henry, I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference?
Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too, so.
I see. But if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentation for the CEO next week?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Excellent. Oh my God. Great pronunciation. Very good. Excellent. Good. Now let's listen to Natalie. Natalie, who is your pair? Natalie, who is your pair? Who is Natalie's pair? ¿Quién es la pareja de Natalie? Who is Natalie's pair?
I am.
All right, Gloribel. So Natalie, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
All right, go ahead.
Jacqueline, tú eres Peter?
Okay. Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference?
Hey, Peter.
Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too.
I see, but if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentation for the CEO next week?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
Sounds great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Nice. That's excellent. That's very good. Thank you very much, Natalie and Jacqueline Gloribel. Thank you. That's great. All right, let's listen to a last pair. Tenemos una última pareja, Ana Beatriz. Who is your pair, Ana Beatriz?
Hola, con Néstor.
Néstor, okay.
Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing the company in the yearly conference?
Hey, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too, so.
I see. But if Julie is attending, who is delivering the representation for the CDO the new suite?
Guess what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
So great. So I am informing the committee about it.
All right. Thank you very much. That's excellent. Thank you. I would like to hear everybody. Me gustaría que lo escucháramos a todos. I would like to hear everybody. But we have to go to the next activity. But I'm sure everybody practiced. Estoy seguro que todos practicaron y lo hicieron muy bien, okay? So thank you for practicing. Thank you very much. All right. Now let's move to the next activity. Vamos a la siguiente actividad. So listen. Now, for the next activity, applying the explanation, aplicando la explicación, applying the explanation, you will organize some words to create sentences. Van a organizar unas palabras para crear las oraciones. Remember the structure. Recuerden la estructura. What is the structure que va primero en la oración que les expliqué? What is first?
Primero va el
nombre, ¿no era?
Sorry, what is first? ¿Qué va primero? What is first?
Primero.
Pronombre.
Primero.
El pronombre. I, you, we, they, it, ajá, the pronoun. O puede ser en vez del pronombre un sujeto. Podría ser un nombre,
sujeto,
like Floribel,
verbo,
Nelson, o could be anything else, right? Any subject, cualquier sujeto o pronombre, okay? Very good. What is second?
El verbo.
The verb.
The verb.
Pero ¿cuál verbo? Which verb?
ING.
Con el ING.
Second.
El are,
yes, el am, is, and is and are. Don't forget it. Que no se les olvide el am, el is y el are.
Is and are.
I am, he is, she is, it is. We are, you are, they are. Don't forget that. Que no se les olvide eso. Don't forget that. Si solo me dicen.
He is, she is it, I am, are you, you are, we are, they are.
Exactly, Mr. Cabarrete. Now listen. If you say, si ustedes dicen, I checking merchandise. The example is incorrect. Si me dicen, we sending the packages. No, it's incorrect. What is correct? We are the merchandise. We are. Okay, so don't forget that. Que no se olvide. Don't forget that. All right. So what is third? ¿Qué va tercero? What is third?
Third.
Verbo.
El verbo con, the verb with. The verb with ing. Now, do I need a phrase in future? ¿Necesito una frase en futuro?
Yes.
The next not necessary, week. But in this case, yes.
Yes, in this case, it's necessary. Or maybe the context of the sentence, right? But it's very necessary, okay? Very good. Antes de que trabajen, ¿tienen alguna pregunta aún de este tema? Do you have any question? No. Okay, very good. Let's move down. Okay, so listen. For this next part, you will work together. And the idea is that you, let me see, it's here. That you organize these sentences. La idea es que organicen estas seis oraciones de la actividad 4. On page 30, en la página 30, on page 30. La número uno ya está hecha, right? So number one is, Jose is receiving the new workers tomorrow. So go to number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, page 30, página 30. Okay, very good. So let's go and work. Vamos a trabajar entonces en equipos. Let's go and work in teams. All right, let's go. Vamos entonces. Okay, let's go and work in teams. Vamos a trabajar en equipos. Let's go and work in teams.
Ok, vamos a ver cómo nos quedó.
Mark is sending the letter the next week.
Ok, Mauricio.
Quiero ver. Oye,
la uno ya está arreglada. José is receiving the new worker tomorrow.
La dos.
La dos sería Mark.
Mark is.
Con la estructura que nos dijo primero.
Who needs help here?
Hey, no, nada más una pregunta.
Yeah.
Es que Mauricio escribió la 2 o la estaba escribiendo y puso al principio the next week Mark is sending the letter.
Okay.
¿Se puede?
Yes, in spoken English you can do it. Cuando en inglés cuando se habla se puede hacer, pero gramaticalmente va al final. It's at the end.
Ah, okay, okay.
Mm-hmm. So you would say, se diría entonces, Mark is sending the letters the next week. It sounds better, suena mejor así al final. Atrás.
Ah, okay, okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, the chair.
All right, no problem.
Okay, sería la segunda, Jane is.
Jane is.
Is working
on the report.
On the reports tonight.
On the report tonight.
Nah, ahí está, ¿eh? Okay. Sí, ¿verdad? James is working on the report tonight.
Yes.
Sí.
Okay, perfect. Vamos a ver. nos queda una cada uno. Vamos a ver, Wendy, ¿cómo queda la cuarta?
Walter is signing the check today.
Signing is the pronunciation. Signing. Yes, the pronunciation is signing. Okay.
Okay, gracias, teacher.
Okay.
Signing the check today. Okay, Mauricio. La más larga te tocó a ti.
Marina is organizing the presentation in the afternoon.
Okay. The presentation
is organizing
in the afternoon. Okay. Guillermo is going to the band tomorrow. Soy raro.
Guillermo is going.
Guillermo is going to the band tomorrow. Teacher is correct.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Yeah, it's okay. Correct.
Okay.
Tomorrow.
Okay.
¿Cómo le quedó la cuatro a usted? Walter is signing the checks today. The checks today. Okay. Teacher, what is the meaning? Signing.
Signing, firmando. Signing is firmando.
Firmando.
Yes.
Ah, firmando. Ajá. Gracias.
Yes.
Firmando de firma, ¿verdad?
Yes, de firmar. Ajá. De firmar un documento.
Signing.
Centenar, no hay al de ahí de artesanías, lo voy a mandar.
Vaya, solo las repetimos, pero no le vayan a poner a Jefferson, porque el niño Jefferson y con cara de ticuna. No.
Ahí Johnny, está hablando de Billy. Le vamos a poner Johnny.
Ay, no. Se tiene que llamar Don José.
I think I am in the room in the wrong class.
That's correct, teacher.
I'm kidding. Did you finish?
Yes.
Okay, you can practice the sentences.
In this moment, that's...
Ya elegí a uno de ustedes para que compartieran una oración, okay? So I will tell you in the...
Espero que sea Abigail.
Sí, Abby no ha hablado nada.
Aquí los tengo anotados.
Abby.
Creo que sí, hablado.
In fact, de hecho, había elegido Juan Carlos, pero pensándolo bien, va a ser Abigail entonces.
Y Abby.
Okay. Lo voy a cambiar entonces. Double change.
No, practice.
Okay. Vaya, la primera, Abby.
La primera es Marquis. No, la primera es la de José.
No, hombre, ese ya está contestado.
Mark is sending the letter the next week.
The next week. Y es letters.
Letters.
Ajá. Y ahora, Roxy, por si le preguntan a usted.
Jane is working on the reports tonight.
Okay. Walter is signing the checks today.
Signing.
Excuse me, signing.
Yeah, it's okay.
Es firma, ¿verdad?
Firmando, ajá, firmando in this case. Como es el gerundio, firmando. Bueno, okay. Va a firmar, perdón, va a firmar.
That's, what are you signing?
Marina is organizing their...
Okay, okay, everybody. So, everybody finished, I guess, right? So listen, I personally selected one member from each group to share one sentence, okay? Seleccioné un miembro de cada equipo para compartir una oración. So let's see, for sentence number two, para la número dos, let me show you the screen. Le voy a compartir el ejercicio. Let me show the exercise. So, for number two, I selected Sarai. So, Sarai, can you share number two, please?
Mark is sending the letters the next week.
Excellent. Mark is sending the letters the next week. Thank you, Sarai. Thank you very much. Number three, Natalie.
Okay. Jen is working on the reports tonight.
Excellent. That's very good. Jane is working on the reports tonight. Very good. Thank you, Natalie. Number four, Gloribel.
Walter is signing the checks today.
Excellent. That's very good. So Walter is signing the checks today. Thank you, Gloribel. So the pronunciation of this word is signing. Signing, okay? Signing. And sign, el verbo sign significa firmar. Sign is firmar, okay? Documents, right? Sign document. Thank you, Gloribel. Number five, let's listen to Jacqueline.
Maria is organizing the presentation the afternoon.
All right, that's excellent. Thank you very much. Marina, right? Marina is, and the pronunciation for this is organizing.
Organizing.
For everybody, para todos. Organizing. Marina is organizing the presentation in the afternoon. Thank you very much. In the afternoon. Thank you, Jacqueline. And number six, Abigail.
Okay. Guillermo is going to the bank tomorrow.
Thank you. That's excellent. Thank you very much. That's great. Excellent. Guillermo is going to the bank. Guillermo is going to the bank tomorrow. Thank you very much. That's great. So, do you have any question about the topic? ¿Tiene alguna pregunta todavía del tema? Do you have any question about the topic? No? Okay. Now is your time.
Teacher. Cuando son negativas.
¿Cuándo son?
Expresiones negativas. En este caso no se dan.
Yes, por supuesto. For example, you can say, I'm not. I am not going to work tomorrow. I am not going to work tomorrow. Or for example, I am not sending the reports on the weekend. Yeah, it's possible. It's possible. You only put not, solo se le agrega el not. I'm not, you're not, she's not. It's possible, es posible. Yo creo que lo vamos a ver más adelante. Any other question? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? No? Okay, perfect. Now listen. Listen carefully. Now this is for you. In this moment, you will, with a pair, you will go and you will create a conversation for your events next week. You will go and create a conversation for your events next week or next month. I don't know. Okay? Using the conversation as an example. Van a usar esa conversación como un ejemplo, as an example. But you will use your own events. Van a usar sus propios eventos, your own events, ¿ok? They can be for next week or for next month. Pueden ser para la otra semana o para el otro mes. I don't know. Yo no sé, ¿ok? You know better. Ustedes saben mejor. So please, try to use real information. Van a usar información real. Real information. So let's go and create the conversation. Ahora sí vamos a crear la conversación de nosotros. About our events. Acerca de nuestros eventos, ¿ok? Are you ready? ¿Están listos? So you can write it, please. Escríbanla, por favor. Write it, please. Okay? So let's go. Vamos entonces. Let's go quickly. I have 16. Yeah. 8. Let me see.
Hello, Ana Beatriz. How are you? What about this year?
Very nice. And you?
I'm nice. And you? I'm fine, Beatriz. Vamos a ver. Cuéntame sobre ti, por ejemplo, podríamos decir, ¿verdad?
Okay.
Speak about you, ¿verdad? Quiero ver cómo dice la pregunta de cuándo cumple años.
Rosana.
When?
Rosana, hello.
When?
Cuéntame acerca de ti. You better say, tell me about you. Tell me about you. Okay?
Okay.
Tell me about you.
Tell me about you.
Yes.
Okay. When is your birthday?
It's my birthday is on December 2nd.
My birthday.
Birthday, Rosana.
December 2nd, ¿verdad? Oh, my birthday is on October 5th. Birthday is on October 5th.
Remember that you need to include the events for next week or next month, right? Necesita incluir los eventos, the events, using the structure I gave you, usando la estructura que les compartí, okay?
Okay, teacher.
All right, continue.
I'm haciendo como la introducción.
Okay, no problem, no hay problema. There's no problem.
Where do you work? Where do you work, Beatriz?
Next week.
Mm-hmm.
Y la respuesta sería I attend him. I attending the client and is the next week.
Voy a como dice con Héctor de Nido contador que vea. A donde dice, a donde tiene su raya, dice, who's what? I am sitting with Hector, the new accountant.
The next week, with Hector.
Le agregamos,
Uh-huh. With who? With un nombre.
The new. Ah, Héctor, está bien. The new account. Account.
Y le pone new account.
Uh-huh.
Accountant.
Y para terminar.
Is writing.
Right.
The report. Next month.
Report. Next week.
Next month.
Okay.
Month.
Ah, next month.
Month.
Sí.
Month.
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 Siempre la pronunciación de la TH month. Es con la lengua entre los dientes, like month.
Month.
Ah, exactly. Month. Month. Month.
Corporación Head.
Corporación Head. Es asistente personal. Aparte de